Somebody wanted me to make a video on what I was playing, the finger picking style I was playing on a freight train. I'm going to do that, but I think because I don't have a video editor, at least I ain't found one yet, and how to edit these things together, and cut out the mistakes and all the crap. I'm going to try to make short videos because if I don't do it that way, it's just going to be one jumbled up mess probably, and it'll probably just confuse you. So I'm just going to do small videos at a time. And if you're already experienced at Travis picking, you probably won't learn too much at all from me, really. But if you're just a beginner and want to learn how to play that, I might can help you. Now I did that song that Freight Train in the key of D. But I've got a capo on the second fret, and I'm playing it in the C position. So if you want to play, try to do this along, at least the bass part along with what I was doing, you can do that. Best thing to do on this Travis picking is start doing this. You want it's alternating bass, and you're always picking with your thumb on this side. And in this case, we're starting on the bottom three strings, and most of them will be on the bottom three strings. You'll be doing this, and all you're doing is you're starting on the C, hitting that E on the second fret out of the chord, hitting that G on the third fret with your third finger, so you like this. Your thumb on your right hand, and just out of that chord right there, your C, you're hitting that bottom G. Now, when you can do that on your bar your F chord, if you know your bar chords, and you can do the same pattern, but you're starting on your sixth string this time and just going sixth, fourth, then fifth, fourth, just like that. Move it up to G. Back to your C. Now, and also sometimes on your G chord, you might be wanting to hit this open G, depending on what you're playing. So in that case, you won't be hitting three strings. You'll just be doing, sometimes you might just be doing the bottom G with probably with your third finger and that open D like this. Open D, bottom G on the third, like that. Now this pattern will work with any bar chord. You can run that all the way up, one fret at a time, A, and so on. Now, and then when you do the open A though, and if you're an A, now this will work like this: A, fourth, bottom E open, fourth, and you're playing that E on the second fret out of your A chord. However you play the A, I'm playing my A with. Like this. Sometimes people might just you might just use your first finger. So if you know that A chord there, and but remember though, I'm talking like I'm in these chords, but remember I'm capoed too. So remember that. So if you got a capo, put the capo on so you can kind of go along with me here. But that would be the open A, Travis picking, open E, starting on that bottom sixth, just playing those bottom three strings back and forth. That would be your E. If you know this four string sort of a bar chord for like D on those chords, it'll still be those bottom strings there, but you'll be doing that with your little finger, jumping down to the sixth string. So it'll still be, the fifth, fourth, sixth, fourth. And that can you can move that all the way up to every chord on the fret on the neck. And so that's a good place to start to learn your Travis picking. You want to practice a lot getting your bass thing down before you start adding any other notes. Now, I'll take my capo off here. And now this is the real C. Without the capo, there's a real C. Same position all you was playing when it was capoed. That's a C, F. Open G would be like that if you're just doing two notes, that open D. So slowly, I'm going to stop there. That's the best thing to do if you don't know anything about Travis Bickle, you don't know how to do it yet. Learn, do the bass first. Get that down. And then when you got that down, you can start adding notes. So I'm going to stop here, and then I'll continue on another video here. Thank you. I hope it helps.